Grab, guys. Okay, guys, I've stolen you. What's the result? Are they? Do you know all of their secret strategies?
The A team involves slark. All I can say.
The A team. It involves slark. Okay.
That's it. That's it. That's the win, apparently.
Wow. Well, slark is banned, so that's a thing.
That was it, and it's all over already.
Oh, no, it's all over. All of your insight. You were supposed to be doing reconnaissance.
They said they'd blame me if it got banned, because apparently I was cheating, so... I'm gonna get one, really.
Yeah. Oh, wow. Well, to be fair, it was banned before you said that it was...
Yeah,
that it was Slark. Ten certainly before it would have been on the stream that it was Slark.
I think they want to do, like, a support Murano with, like, a Roman strap.
No, well,
like
Murano's...
Like a Shadow Demon or...
Okay. Oh, wow. Quick ban, or quick picks and bans coming out. That's interesting. It's actually Blue, who's tagged himself up again as Nice, is like he used to a while back. Or what did he... feel like... No, never mind. I'm lying. He was Blue first. I'm like, I... felt like there was, like, when he first started playing with us, which I think was actually before your time, guys.
Yes, yes.
I think he used to tag himself up as something else, but actually, I think I'm lying. I think it was just, he was always Blue. But, I'm just getting confused because he goes by, like, 8 billion different names. But he's actually drafting instead of Chilla, so that's interesting.
Yeah, he drafted last night as well, I'm pretty sure.
Mm-hmm.
The second game we played.
I gotta say, though, I am a little bit afraid, because Pat's team actually has their full roster, 100% no stand-ins.
Finally.
I feel like we should give them a medal for that. Like,
yeah, they should get something for this. It's been a while since... Well, they haven't actually done it yet, have they? They haven't had a full game.
No. Well, barely any teams actually manage to get a full game. Like, most of the time, there's one stand-in or two stand-ins. Actually, A-team as well, because Moodfo's... They wifed him. He's their permanent stand-in. They've only got one stand-in. So there's actually only one stand-in in this game total. So,
which is a good stand-in to pick up.
So it's pretty good. Yeah, Mood, like... He also, Mood on his thing, didn't want to be a stand-in. And I felt really bad making him a stand-in, but he didn't have...
Yeah.
Like, he didn't know a schedule in advance at all. So I couldn't,
in
good conscience, like, put him on a team and then, like, try and schedule that team and then have... their, like, standout player probably not be there at any of their matches was, like, an issue, but...
That's fair. But it all worked out, so...
It all worked out in the end. But, yeah. Yeah. So they've got a Luna, which makes me happy, because I get to see a Luna.
They definitely should go check Roche, as Wing just pointed out. They've already got two auras, Fury Swipes, and minions, or whatever, to summon Treants.
Treants. I hope he has cute Treants too, whoever picks him. Or whoever uses him.
Treants would be great. I don't know why people are banning Terrorblade, though, because it's not a good... I don't think it's that good. People, like, get really afraid of it, and it's not good early on. Especially if you're, like, playing against a team that knows what they're doing, and actually talks and communicates to kill him.
Mm-hmm.
Need so much space and farm to actually do pretty well.
Be able to do stuff, yeah. Oh, I pick the... So A-team picks up the Ogre Magi, the recently buffed Ogre Magi. I have played against this Ogre Magi. I haven't played him yet since the patch, but I have gotten absolutely destroyed by him. So I'm really excited for this game. Looking at these two teams, looking at Pat's got his full roster, which we've said sort of from the time of the... from draft day going, this is a scary roster. And then up against... Don't tell Docs I said this, but up against Docs, up against Blue, and Moodfo and Chilla with Sharkbait as their stand-in, I feel like this could potentially be a really good game. So, I'm quite...
Overall, I think they're pretty equal on scale, which will make it a good game. It won't be like... It'll be nice and even, and won't be like a stomp. Or...
Mm-hmm. And then, like, watch, as soon as we say this, it's, like, a ridiculous stomp or something.
Yeah, and then they just, like, five-man ball him, don't we?
But God, I hope this is a really good game, because I'm so hyped right now for a really good game. Especially, like, considering that we have 28 games, like, the hype level has not entirely been sustained. My hype takes a little more to get going, but I have my hype going. An OD! They've actually picked an OD.
They made you happy and it's fine.
Everything's coming up, Amanda. It's so good.
Now for the dirge offlane.
Yeah, they're definitely going to pick a dirge next. That definitely wouldn't ruin their entire team or anything.
5 seconds.
I imagine it's a... Maybe it's a carry Mirana now?
Maybe, yeah, maybe because you revealed their strategy to the world at large.
I revealed the strats. They had to like adjust to the reveal of the strat. And that, mm-hmm.
Everything changes.
They lied while I was in the TeamSpeak, and then as soon as I got moved, they just.
This was their plan all along. Yeah. Actually, they were like, "Well, we've got Kaz in here. We'll tell him dirty, rotten lies, and then." If one of the other teams is listening. Also, they go with a Storm for their mid. Okay, a Storm versus an OD. Okay. I feel like... I mean, it is Mudfo Storm, but he's going to be up against Ellen Pudge OD. So I'm...
Yeah.
This is going to be interesting, guys. It's an even mid, I think. This is going to be interesting.
Nice. Yeah.
Man. All right.
Docs on bottom. This is going to be interesting. I can't wait for this one.
They're making Docs support, which makes me happy. Oh, no, he's not support because it'll be chill.
He will support, but I just want to keep an eye on these arrows. I may or may not keep a count.
All right, I think you definitely should. And put it up as stats. All right, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to Season 2 of TBFFTYNHO. We're in the group stages now, and today we've got an awesome game for you. We've got... A-Team versus Fruit, Fake Root. Oh, by the way, turn on your mic in-game, guess, so that people watching the relay... Yeah. And playing for A-Team, actually, we've got an early smoke, but it actually only hits on two. And they smoke in the base, which is a bit premature. But we've got Mudfo, their kind of permanent adopted team member. He's going to be playing that Storm Spirit. Dox is going to be on that Potom. Chilla on the recently buffed to Oblivion, not to Oblivion, but to the opposite of Oblivion. Ogre Magi. Nice is going to be on that Viper. And they've got a stand-in, will be Sharkbait, and he'll be playing an Ancient Apparition. They do Scout out Roche just to make sure that with the Furious Swipes, with the aura and everything, that they aren't actually doing it. Just being safe, covering their bases. And playing for Fruit, who apparently didn't plug in their team. We've got Freak and Chair. We've actually got the entire team, no stand-ins. We've got Freak and Chair is going to be on playing the safe lane farming Ursa. Will the real Apple 322, who changed his name to 322 after his decision as the Void that last game to jump into the enemy team, chrono them all, and then feed an Aegis and die. He's going to be playing that safe lane. Oh, actually, it's a safe lane farming Luna. What am I talking about? And a jungle Ursa. Pat, team captain, is going to be playing that support Venge. Headed toward the middle lane, we've got Ellen Pudge, also known as Jay Wong is my hero in Twitch, and he will be playing that mid-OD. Very exciting matchup here. And then headed to the bot lane, we've got an offlane Prophet, and that's going to be played by Trickster. So, we gotta say, who are your eeps on? Who are your eeps on, Pat?
My eeps on. So far. I want to say A-Team right now, just because... feel like Viper versus Ursa wins. Viper wins.
Mm-hmm.
And already some engagement and less of one arrow missed already.
Alright. Freaking Chair can no longer control his actions. He's a bear! He's a bear!
So yeah, so far. They got a nice aggressive tri-lane, a defensive tri-lane up top. Mm-hmm. But they can definitely make kills with it though, with arrow and there.
Well, and I'm not sure how much of a tri-lane it is when the Ursa's gonna be wanting to more go to the jungle than necessarily be in lane.
Looks like he's a support Ursa.
Really?
A support Ursa. Yeah, he's stacking and pulling. I think PvP did this.
Yeah, I guess he is. Huh, okay. Alright.
Worked out pretty well in the end. He went like Hex and Blink and disabled everyone. It was really good. Yeah.
So it's interesting that the lane matchup actually didn't end up being... I assumed that it was going to be Mudfo and the Storm was going to be in the mid lane. But meanwhile, up top, we've got... looks like they got a stun and an Ogre Magi stun on Freakin' Chair. They need one more something? Anything? He doesn't have anything. No stun for 6 seconds. They do actually get it. They do get the first blood. They feed one immediately. They might be in trouble, though. Chilla might be in trouble. Pat actually is going to fall as well. So that's two for two in this top lane already. Action, action not denied. He's got Starstorm, and he would get a, he would get the double proc on it if he had fired it off, but he doesn't fire it off. Docs, please, why you feed? Alright, we're showing that fight. We're showing that fight recap, guys. So the gold change, both teams got a lot of gold there. Dire's slightly better, even though they got first blooded, even though Radiant got the first blood. Yeah, they made up better because they got 3 kills instead of 2.
Yeah.
But yeah. Dox, where was your Starstorm, Dox? Why?
I like the how they put this storm safe lane. That's well thought. They knew the OD was going to come mid. They knew it would be a hard time to
get
that storm safe and get a nice, fast Orchid, Bloodstone.
And he's actually, yeah, he's leading the board as far as last hits go. He's ahead of either of the mid laners. And the mid laners, the Vipers, not doing nearly as badly in this mid lane. It's not nearly as hard for him as it would have been for the storm. So, yeah. Very nice, very nice. Decision making.
You can rely on Mood to get last hits, which is a good thing to know.
Yeah. Oh, somebody operating system commented on Cat on the Luna Luna Mirana showdown cat fight.
No supports checking runes, which is interesting. They seem to just want to fight up top, I think.
Even with this new patch and the changes in runes and the bounty runes.
People haven't quite adjusted to that yet. It's hard to adjust to like your supports actually leaving the lane and going to check runes and meanwhile.
Unless, you know, you were in a bracket where initially that actually happened, but none of us are there, so it's fine. It keeps freaking me out because I see no hero, no Radiant hero in mid lane because he gets astraled. And I'm like, what, where did the Viper, oh, never mind. He's just invisible. You know, as soon as we say that, OD actually gets a bounty, which is helpful. As I haven't actually seen a bounty in a bottle before. It looks so pretty.
I've learned this from Currency. He did actually... like, constructive criticism told me not to use it straight away because you actually get more XP and gold if you leave it in there for a minute.
It's not like, it's not actually a lot of it, but if you can even hold on to it for 2 minutes, if you're completely fine as far as your thing goes, then as far as your health and mana goes, then it's actually really, it gives you a slight amount of more, but it's like 4 more experience or something ridiculous like that.
Some drawings on the map. They want to go mid, but then Pat's going to fall.
Oh, Pat! It's alright, Pat. We won't tell anybody about that. But you know what? You know what? Dox found his Starfall button. So,
And he hit an arrow as well. Let me see.
Wow.
And hit Starfall.
It's crazy. Looking
pretty good so far.
Oh, I have to do the courier comp, but I have to do it when neither courier's morphed. So right now, they have a Pudgling. Ew. So I'm gonna, Radiant, unless they picked, a boar.
When Chilla uses the courier for Radiant, look then. Is this his courier?
Oh, it's actually, Meanwhile, it is. Top, this is Chilla's courier. Engage,
and looks like Apple's going to fall. Another arrow from Dox hits.
So that's been pretty good. Yeah, so I think Radiant wins courier comp.
And bot lane now. Trickster's dead to Storm.
Oh, wow. So getting off to an early advantage for 18.
We can chase just farming at the jungle on this. That's going to do another stack. I like the mid matchup. Ellen Pudge is doing really well. He's like astraling blue as soon as he goes to last hit, so he can actually last hit. He's timing him really nicely.
Yeah, and it keeps him, he's ahead, but he's only ahead by 3 or by even 2 last hits. So the CS is still remarkably even. I mean, both of these are heroes that you kind of don't want to have to face in mid.
Yeah, so. They're both like annoying with each other, really.
Well, meanwhile, but Pudge, getting those runes. He gets a hate, or he gets a bounty after he triggers his haste, gets triggered. And that's sort of it's the second bounty he's actually gotten. So that's going to be helpful for him on top of having the advantage in last hits. Oh, but in the bot lane,
I was just about to point out how much CS Mood actually has at this point.
Yeah, part of that, though, it's worth noting, is that Trickster is feeding him some Treants, but Treants aren't actually as much. So that might be slightly misleading to see that he has 51 CS, because some of that CS isn't going to be lane creeps.
He is actually maxing his treants as well, which I don't know is a good idea, especially with a storm who has nice CC and can just clear waves with his first his remnant.
Yeah.
If he just got it's TP just and maybe him, it's good just, to make kills.
Yeah, giving him more gold. Meanwhile, we've got Shark is actually still smoked. The smoke pops. They actually get the disable on Pudge, and they bring him down. Chilla might feed for this. No, Chilla's okay. Shark bait as well, trying to get away. Trickster actually can't get in range for a sprout. Oh, he can now. No, why did you run that way, Shark? Why did you run that way? But he might actually be fine. Possibly.
Trickster actually TP'd behind the tower there. He could have just been more aggressive and stepped forward. That would have been an easy kill on Chilla, which is a shame.
Mm. Oh, yeah.
Who's back now? It looks like he's going awkward first, which is good. They're going to need it against the OD and the Natures.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think so. Trickster potentially gets this kill, but he's not moving away from the ice vortex. So he's deading the ice vortex with cold feet on him, and he's not moving out of the radius. So he could be in trouble. I don't think he actually gets this. He doesn't get this kill if the cold feet procs, and Trickster's doing nothing to stop the cold feet from proccing. So
he is going the EU build as well. The free null talismans. They can.
Oh,
the one that Docs likes to go all the time.
That sort of crazy build into the
blade
mode.
I really don't like it, but I suppose people like it. So
it's a really man fighty build. I remember it. So I first saw that build when Currency tried to 3-2-2. He bet all of his eeps against us when we were just doing, like, party matchmaking. And so he bet against us, and he's like, I'm trying something I saw in a pub, guys. And it was this. And he was like, holy shit, how is this working? Why is this working? No. And he lost all of his eeps because the build actually works, it turns out, even though it's ridiculous. And then, like, the next day I saw on Reddit, somebody was like, what's with all these Nature's Prophets with null talismans and blade mail? And then somebody, like, explained the math and the damage and, like, kind of how the build functions. But yeah. A little bit of in-pause coordination coming out from the A-team, taking advantage. Like, Pat was trying to...
Mask. Yeah, he's just waiting for his ping to settle down.
Yeah.
Bimmy's on to try ping.
Let me,
There is a Morbid Mask pickup on, Ursa now, so we can jungle a bit more efficiently.
Let's see what is. Yeah, Pat's still got 400 milliseconds ping. That's
probably why he's supporting, to be honest.
That's possible. His his internet.
On the intro.
Oh yeah, so Shark survives. Did the cold feed actually proc? I tabbed away to look at ping.
I don't think so. I might have. I'm not sure.
So how's Apple? So up in this lane, Apple's farming away, but he's not really keeping up in CS with the storm at all.
He's sitting 3-1, which is pretty decent. Like, considering it was this big fight around here that gave him a lot of kills and money.
That's true. That does help. As far as net worth, he's pretty much keeping up with the storm, even though he's far behind on CS. But, I mean, some of that storm CS or Treant, so. Probably accounts for some of the evenness.
This could be more dangerous than the Weaver, because he played Weaver yesterday, didn't he? He had complete free farm. We didn't gank him once. It was our fault. But meanwhile, top, they're going to smoke and pot him up top to try and get some kills. But I think they spotted it. Yeah, I think Mood gave it away, farming on the bottom lane.
But they're wrapping around. This is, I think they're in trouble. I think Apple needs to be careful.
Apple's got to run back.
Unless they actually manage to get killed by Dara. Scream at him. Scream at him. He's right there. Scream at him. He does, and he sees him.
Because he was playing the Weavy yesterday, and he had he's going to jump out and maybe find himself a kill.
Yeah, it looks like this is going to be definitely a kill. Trickster can't really get away. Yeah, you can't.
Yeah, this is what I'm talking about. It's a lot more dangerous than the Weaver he played yesterday, because he has the ability to get around the map and disable and do a lot more damage than Weaver, who could just sit back and split push and then show up to fights.
Dire's bottom tower is being attacked.
Dip in and out, do a lot of damage.
Yeah, really in the mid lane. So what they do have to be afraid for, though, is an OD that gets farm. So an OD that gets farm can be terrifying. Like, just the amount of the shoulders that an OD is capable of growing are so wide. Like,
yeah, sure.
And Ellen Pudge is quite a player, so I think, yeah, I think they do potentially. I mean, at least it's against a Storm who has, you know, who is an intel hero, at least is going to get some intelligence, especially his Orchid when he finishes it will help a little bit with that, but, I mean, not a ton, but a little. And if he puts his boots on mana, maybe it doesn't hurt him as much.
He ferried himself a Clarity and Salve.
Mm-hmm. No, I mean, as far as how much damage his ult is going to do on him. Is
oh,
it, he
yeah,
has...
did it change a bit, didn't it? That thing
did
changed.
It?
Like, the way it, like, uses mana or something, I read.
Oh, you mean, Storm changed. He got more mana efficient. His ult. Yeah. I meant, I'm talking about OD's ult. I'm talking about how much damage OD will do on Storm is potentially...
Oh, yeah,
like,
yeah,
at least
yeah,
he's not a hero that has, low intel to begin with. At least, like, that's...
And they're
going
to try rush now, actually. They're trying to
But they're pinged, but they can't really ping it.
Oh,
they can't really sneak
shark.
It.
Oh,
Shark doesn't have a 6. I was like, oh, what a beautiful ice blast. Oh, no, you can't. You're 4.
If he had stepped any further, he would have just died there.
Mm-hmm.
Three heroes
so he sees, he got the vision with the vortex as well. He's like, yep, they're there. Yeah. They're there, guys. They're still there. There's nothing they could really
Vlad's
do.
Vlad's and Aegis up on this, and then boots.
Oh, yeah, that's true. They did go for that. They did go for a certain amount of greed with their lineup, sending Freakin' Chair, sort of semi-supporting this lane, but also heading to the jungle. So I don't feel like A-Team is far ahead in kills, and their Storm is getting crazy farm, but, yeah, but I think Fruit isn't really behind in a meaningful way. Yeah, the gold is pretty even, the XP pretty even.
And Mu's gonna kill bot again, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, it's got another kill
there
bot.
There it goes. They can't.
More money towards his Orchid.
Yeah, this Nature's Prophet can't go back to that lane alone. Like,
no, he needs to.
He really can't. Like, it just can't happen. Not if Mood has any mana at all.
I think killing this guy is gonna be really hard. You need a nice lockdown, a hex for a Storm.
Yes. Yeah.
They have the Vengeful Stun, but he can just zip away from that because it's such a long cast range.
I think as well, Trickster, so the build that he's going is he's meant to be going straight into the Blade Mail now, so that he can man fight, and start being aggressive and TPing to supports and forcing them to fight him, and if they hit him...
He could go top now, look, Dox is low, look, they're all low top.
Yeah, they are. Oh, real Apple, he is in trouble.
Blue's mech
He needs to get out of there. Oh, nice, Blue is so fast. Yeah, his mech is up, and that haste room so good. Oh, he hit another arrow. Blue's actually going to go in on this, and it looks like it's going to go well for him. Yeah. And that's a quick double.
I don't want to side for Pat, but I feel like he'd know. If I feel like he wanted to dodge that arrow, but he actually couldn't.
Yeah, with the ping.
Well, top.
Oh!
The courier's going
to
go.
He almost gets the courier, but he doesn't quite, and Mudfo's here. Oh, you can't escape him. Oh, God.
And some nice drawing comes out from
Yeah.
They want wards, I think, there, so they can see if they're going to get died by...
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, this Treant should be... this Nature's side should be doing more than just AFK Cliff Jungle right now.
Yeah, he needs to be. And he needs to be. And so he went for building Treads after his Nulls rather than going straight into the Blade Mail, and I feel like he needed...
Yeah.
If you're going this build, you commit to it.
Yeah,
and you go for the Blade Mail, and you start... running and finding supports on the map to force a man fight you. And
I suppose even if you die, it's helpful because you're doing damage to them if they focus you with, like, Blade Mail and stuff, as long as your carries can get some kills.
Yeah.
Especially the way that the gold works now.
Yeah. But let's look at... Yeah, so let's look at what Ellen Pudge has actually got. So he's got a Null and Treads and an 1100 gold.
Imagine a 4 staff or
mm-hmm.
a mech pickup unless they're...
Stupendous!
I don't think
Venge is getting one anytime soon.
Oh, that's true. I guess there's not... But mech would be quite an odd pickup on OD because it doesn't give you intel. He needs intel for damage. 4 staff is so good on him, so...
4 staff's good, yeah.
I feel like that's what's coming. 4 staff, or he builds into eventually getting his sheep. And Sheep's going to be so good for them. No, there's nobody there. Sheep's going to be so good for them against Mudvo. Like, they need it so desperately. And Apple's in trouble again. He's in so much trouble again. He can't even. Yeah. And he's silenced and orchided. And
OD ult was used, but to kill Blue.
Okay. Let's actually see that, because I don't know. That just does that. It doesn't show us the other. The fallout from the other kill.
There you go. Who tried to use his mech, use his bottle, but he couldn't get it.
Not yet. But that's it. That's a kill. So he's 1-1. He's got 2k gold. It looks like they do want to defend this tower. I'm not sure if that's necessarily something they can do, though. Freakin' Chair eats an arrow, gets pulled into the pool. He was all alone. He needed not to do that. The Sprout comes out, but it's actually off the Mars. And what an Ice Blast actually hits on so many. Oh, and the Ogre just cleans up as well. Real Apple throws out his ult, but it's not going to do as much as they need it to do, because out comes the Moonlight Shadow, and nobody's got detection. Okay, so it looks like Sturm's building the new Bloodstone. With that Sol Ring pickup.
I already liked Sol Ring, like first item, like pickup on
Storm,
especially in the safe lane because it gives you like nice time to mana for jump and for stat grab and nice farming. But now you can get it anyway for Bloodstone, which is really good.
Yeah, it was a sort of indirect Storm buff, I guess. Alright, how we doing? So, Ellen Pudge, actually, he's 2-1-1 now. He picked up another kill in there. He's gonna get another bounty. And he's actually got 2,600 gold. I'm really curious what he's... Zipping on Pat. Oh, goodbye, Pat.
He is picking up BKB. No,
how foolish to think that you could actually ward their... ward, you know. As though...
Pudge
as though
could be
warding.
Dead mid, actually. Oh no, he's gonna live.
Nice actually. Might be in a little bit of trouble. He's okay. He's so tanky, he's got that mech, he's got everything. Yeah, so quite defensive. Oh man.
This is getting out of hand now.
Yeah, it really is. It really is. I mean, OD's got broad shoulders, but they need to be pretty broad at
this
point.
Broad.
But again, I mean, comeback mechanic. They're not that far ahead, actually, but they're starting to get... If they can get a kill on that Storm...
Yeah, that's,
they
can
get
the
a kill on
say.
That Storm.
Yeah. Like, it'd be great if they could, but I don't know how they do it, now that he's got a lot of int behind him.
Mm-hmm.
Nice mana pool. He can just zip away. They got no real hex yet, or...
Yeah, I mean that they need the hex on OD, but it's so far away, especially because he needs a BKB. So the first game with the complete roster for Fruit, not going as planned.
Dox has just been farming this whole time as well, Top, I realized. He hasn't actually left the lane once. I think he left just then to throw an arrow.
He's decided I am carry now.
Yeah. The very idle natures. He hasn't progressed much in items for the past, like, five.
Oh, that arrow, though? Yeah, that arrow into Orchid, into everything else. He's just doomed. Trickster. Nature's Prophet TP's in here, but yeah, you need to not be anywhere
it's
near.
It's too late. I think it's too late now. With all this TPing in.
Yeah. Oh god. Oh god. So they actually get a kill on the Ogre, which is pretty necessary for them. But where is Pudge? Pudge died. So that was one for three in that little engagement, because Luna was already dead, and Trickster as well. Potentially gonna die. He needs to Sprout TP, maybe? Because Mudvo doesn't actually have enough mana for, Oh no, he does have enough mana for Paul. I lied. He's just dead.
This game's looking over, I think.
Yeah, they didn't. So they sent a Treant against the Storm, and the Treant was feeding him. Or sorry, they sent They sent a Nature's Prophet against Storm, and he was just He was maxing his treants and sending his treants. His treants are adorable, but they are a pretty nice source of gold for somebody who has easy wave clear, like Storm does. They didn't challenge him at all. He got a few kills. Nobody decided to rotate. Nobody decided to help him. They wanted to sort of make space for the, for the mid OD, and that just wasn't gonna
and his
happen.
And Bloodstone, I think, is here.
Oh, God.
Yeah, he has his Bloodstone now. So now the death ball continues even more.
Yeah.
Maybe they'll get the next Rosh Rishi soon.
Yeah, I mean, the net worth isn't as bad as you would think. Like, looking at these scores, you go, oh, the net worth's going to be out of control. But it's actually under 7,500 in favor, like, the total difference. Like, if we look at the actual net worth, OD isn't that far behind. I mean, well, yeah, he's pretty far behind Storm, but then it's Mirana, but then it's OD. He's actually still ahead of the Viper. And all of the supports, or all of the people that have been playing support, except for Pat, who's just had a really rough game, is actually... that self in prison actually means that he can't participate at all. He also doesn't have his ult to cast. Just got caught up. Oh, it's rough. Oh, it's rough.
11 charges already on this stone.
Yeah, they needed to look at their team and say, hey, look, there's going to be that Storm. We need to make sure that Storm doesn't get shit.
They needed to go before 6. They needed to just rotate, get people down there.
Yeah, they needed to challenge that farm. Oh, they take the stack as well.
He was level 6.
He did. And as well, like, sending that Nature's Prophet against him alone... Like, as soon as he hits 6, you can't sprout him. You can't get away. That's not going to happen. Like,
can't sprout yourself.
It's not, that's not a problem of him playing. That's a problem of, it's a Storm Spirit. He can always just zip out of your trees.
Yeah.
You know, you have zero lockdown. Luna, well, meanwhile, dying top as well while I'm watching Rush. It's just...
Walk away and let the Orchid damage do it to him.
Yeah. Cool guys, don't look at explosions. Alright. And this Luna's had such a hard time as well. 3 and 5 at this point. They don't have... Yeah, he just doesn't have the farm on him that he needs.
Yeah. There hasn't been much item progression on anyone on Dire side for the past 10 minutes now.
Yeah, it's true. OD still doesn't have his BKB.
Ogre Club.
He bought up these items, the Ogre Club and the Mithril. He bought those up in one fell swoop with all that gold that he was holding on to. And then nothing since then. Like, he's been slowly building towards it, but he just keeps getting caught out. He doesn't have the space to get the farm he needs to grow his shoulders big enough to fight this form. Oh, yeah, it looks like Dox is gonna feed. Alright, they got something. Let me look at that teamfight recap. Come up. Show me the teamfight recap, please. There it is. Alright, so let's see what happens. So they actually got 1,300 gold total out of that, because they're far enough behind. They got 1,300 gold, 2,600. Oh, well. Goodbye. Farewell, friends. Ellen Pudge as well is dead. Self-astrals, but, like, there's no... Like, it's just gonna, when he comes out of the astral, just gonna be in worse position. There really aren't people to come. Luna's under-farmed. I mean, what do you really expect the offlaner to do? The offlane Shree, who's, at this point, who's on 2 and 8, can't really do anything. I think we are actually in call it, Kim. We are actually in call it territory.
There it is. You called it. You called
there
the call
it is. It. I called the call it, guys. But yeah, that was, I mean, that's just...
That was a safe farm.
Yeah. So I don't feel like it's a skill mismatch between the players that much, because we have quite...
No, it's more of the hero lineup.
It was the hero lineup, and it was where... It was a focus lineup. Like, they focus that Storm, they keep that Storm from going 16-0. This game looks very different. But they didn't do anything at all, especially if you look and you're like, okay, this is their standout player, this is who's meant to sort of equal out our Ellen Pudge and Freakinger, and they didn't shut him down the way.